everyone, welcome to today's lesson on Maslow's hierarchy of needs. The purpose of this lecture is to introduce the five needs of Maslow's hierarchy, help learners understand how each individual is motivated by needs, and lastly, allow learners to be able to identify how people are affected by their environment. By the end of this lecture, you will be able to identify the five needs that make up Maslow's hierarchy, explain the five needs in detail, and then generate an activity that integrates the five needs. Before we begin, think about these questions. What is motivation and what motivates you? Is it your friends, family, or money? And what else? Abraham Maslow, a psychologist, was interested to understand what exactly motivates people. He created the hierarchy of needs and explained that our life experiences cause us to fluctuate between levels of hierarchy. For example, once you find a stable job, security, and freedom from fear, you will move up from physiological to safety needs. However, if you have recently gone through a divorce, the social level of your hierarchy may be affected. Our needs is a lack of something that we require or desire. So basically, our needs are what motivates us to act. Maslow stated that in order to meet your higher needs, you must first satisfy your lower basic needs. For example, if you want to reach for social needs, you must first be able to satisfy your physiological and safety needs. The first stage in Maslow's hierarchy is the physiological need. More commonly known as our basic needs, these needs are necessary for life. If unmet, the human body cannot function. These physiological needs include food, water, oxygen, sleep, protection from extreme temperatures, and sensory needs such as hearing, seeing, feeling, and tasting. This is why schools, workplaces, and other managements provide lunch breaks, rest breaks, and wages that are enough to purchase the essentials of life. After our physiological needs are met, we require safety needs. These needs include freedom from fear, being secured in an environment, and the presence of order and stability. This is why managements provide retirement benefits, a safe working environment, and a job security. The third stage of Maslow's hierarchy of needs is the social needs. Also known as love and belonging, we tend to desire social acceptance, friendships, and love. In order to meet these needs, we engage in social activities with others and have romantic and familial attachments. We also work in cooperative learning groups and participate in classes, clubs, and communities. The fourth stage is esteem. Esteem is basically the need to be respected by others and ourselves. We need to feel important and worthwhile through respect, approval, and appreciation. We earn respect from others through awards, recognition, fame, and attention. And we earn self-respect through achievements, strength, and self-confidence. Self-actualization is the summit of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. It is the need to obtain our full potential as well as personal growth and discovery. Other needs include justice, wisdom, and truth. Unlike lower stages, this need is not always fully satisfied. We have now covered all five of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. This slide contains a summarized version of what we have just learned. Please feel free to come back to this slide when completing your assignment as it would help you. For your assignment, you will have to formulate an activity that is related to a real-life situation and write down which motive is taking precedence and which is being sacrificed. Answers should be posted on a forum. The purpose of this assignment should help you understand how Maslow's theory is applied to real-life experiences. Now that we've come to the end of this lesson, I hope you've learned how to identify human needs according to Maslow's hierarchy, recognize that all human beings have to satisfy their basic needs before any other need. Also, going back to the question I asked you at first, what motivates you? And what level of Maslow's hierarchy of needs do you believe you are in? I hope you have enjoyed this lesson, and please remember to post your answers in the forum. If you have any difficulty completing the assignment, please email me.